football fans, here we go with what they call the second season. The playoffs start Friday night. We're right here at home on the show here this evening. We've got, of course, Coach Courtney, the Rocket Hall of Famer. And we have a future Rocket Hall of Famers, maybe, right here, these guys, Caden Howard and Camron Belchler. And we're going to talk to these guys. Caden's a sophomore, Cam's a junior. And we're going to talk to them on the show here tonight, brought to you by Whitetail Properties and the Mark Williams Land Team. Also in cooperation with the following partners, we're bringing to you our show this week. First United Bank, Par 4 Plastics, Hodges Sports and Apparel, C-Plant, Federal Credit Union, Riley Tool and Machine, USA Mortgage, Derek Myers, The Heritage at Marion Golf and Pool, Deer Lakes Golf Course, Colonel Ag, KB Pharmacy, Johnson's Furniture and Appliance, YTG Insurance, Tanner Tabor, Frazer Law Firm, Full Body Fitness Studio, Livingston Hospital, a Deaconess affiliate, H&H Home and Hardware, and Farmers Bank and Trust. Coach Courtney, you were at the big gala the other night. It was like the H&H and Farmers Bank show, wasn't it? I mean, those guys cleaned up all the awards. Yeah, it was good to see you at a big big event like that in Marion. Yeah. It's like a big formal. You had your cowboy hat and all dressed up. Yeah, it looked good.
I appreciate it.
Looked good. Yeah, your wife looked better.
Yeah. Thank my wife. You guys did a great job, though. It was a great event. It was pretty cool.
It was a lot of fun. Chamber of Commerce put on their annual award show. And this is an award-winning show right here, isn't
That's
it?
Right.
Here we go. We got a lot to talk about, so let's get right into it. We have Todd County Central rolling in here Friday night. 7 p.m. kickoff. This will be the first round of the Class 2A playoffs. Now, Crittenden County is 6-4 on the season after winning last week, closing out the regular season at Callaway County with a win. And Todd Central is going to come in here at 5-5, 5 wins, 5 losses. Now, hey, they're on a 2-game win streak, Coach Courtney. They've beaten Edmondson County and Warren Central the last 2 weeks, and their other wins this season were against Ohio County, a team that we beat, and Stewart County, Tennessee, the team that we played a few years ago down there and kind of spanked pretty good down in Tennessee. But this Todd Central team, they have some athletes on there. We'll get into that in just a second. But first thing I want to talk about is how we keep getting disrespected a bit by the polls, don't we, Coach Corey? I mean, you know, in 1A, it took us many years to kind of get that reputation built up, and we started getting a little love, you know, from the folks, I think, even on the other side of the state. But now you look at the RPI. Mm-hmm. The RPI were number 7, okay? Murray's not even in the top 10 in the RPI. We're number 7. Mayfield's number 2. Ocath is number 1, okay? Mm-hmm. Two teams we've seen. One's in our region. One's in our district. And then if you look at the Courier-Journal, which is putting together the poll now, Mayfield's number 4, Lexington Christian's number 1, Beechwood's number 2, Catholic's 3, Mayfield's there at 4. We are 9. Murray's ahead of us, and we beat them. Murray's ahead of us at 8. Figure it out. What do you got? You guys got any? Come on. I need to understand this. Help me understand it. What are you getting? No respect?
No respect.
How do you get it?
Just keep doing what we do, I guess.
Yeah, you got to do it. You got to do it Friday nights out there on the green, don't you? Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you know, I mean, you think we beat these teams? You know, we're new in 2A and beat Murray, and they still keep ranking us above. Does that bother you? Cam, what do you think?
It bothers me a lot.
How bad? Mm-hmm. I mean, here, let me move this mic over here.
We just keep getting disrespected, and we just got to show them that we can play.
Yeah. What do you think you can do about it this week?
I mean, If I get the ball, then.
You'd like to have the ball, don't you?
Yeah.
Show out a little bit?
Yeah.
Like to show out? Both of you guys like to get the ball. I know some of the times I walk down the sideline and you're over looking around and say, man, I got to get more touches. and Coach Courtney and Coach Barry are trying to figure out how to get you guys the ball more. I know.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah, it's tough. We've talked about it all year. There's so many of them. I mean, all of them need touches. He needs touches. He needs touches. Tyler Belt needs touches. Gabe Kelly needs touches. Case needs touches. Tyler Belt needs touches. whoever I've missed needs touches. Yeah. Gatton, the running backs. We ain't talking about running back. Yeah, everybody needs touches. Micah needs his touches. Yeah.
How many you need a game? I mean, let's lobby coach here. I mean, he can take it to the OC.
Yeah. I mean, my preferable number is like 6 to 8, probably.
6 to 8. Yeah. Well, you got 11 catches. A couple of weeks ago, which was too shy of the single game record. Not a bad job for a sophomore. Expect a lot out of you over the next few years. Caden, I know a lot of people do. Of course, this is your nephew, and I know, you know, it's hard to get a little love from your uncle sometimes because I think it's tough like that when it's family. Of course, now Cameron, he's out of my place a lot too, so he's kind of like family in a way, you know. So but we'll give him a little love to make him feel good. So we'll get with these guys, talk to them a little bit more here in a moment. First of all, we want to take a look at this Rebel offense. Coach Courtney, I haven't done a whole lot of homework on these guys. The quarterback, Redding, I guess, is Reading. It's R-E-D-I-N-G. I don't know if it's Reading or Redding. Number 15, he's thrown for 916 yards, 11 touchdowns, just 5 INTs on the season. Not too bad of a ratio, not too bad. What are you seeing on film on this guy?
He's a freshman, so yeah, point that out. He's a really good athlete, scrambles really well. For a freshman, I think he's an extremely good player. And not saying just in general he's not either. But coming along this late in the year, he's, you know, probably growing up to more of a sophomore. I think he makes good decisions. He really scares me the most, scrambling. They want to run the football, but they, like you said, they got everything as far as they have big guys up front. They have a mobile quarterback. They have a good running back who's also a freshman. And they got especially two guys that really stand out wide. They can really make plays, extend the field, do things with small catches like screens and things and really make explosive plays out of them. So really scary football team. They really are as far as what they have. If they come out and they can be really explosive offensively.
Mm-hmm. They kind of been up and down. You know, they didn't beat Ohio County by, I think it was 19-0, if I'm not mistaken. Was that final? Of course,
I believe that's correct.
We handed to them pretty good. It's hard to get much of a read on, you know, Webster County. They lost to Webster County 47-28. And, you know, Webster went on a run after we beat them to open the season. So that's a tough one, too. Catholic beats them 57-7. You know, how do you get a read off any of that? We know what that is. You know, they beat Russellville this year. Russellville's down. They beat Russellville 41-6. But, you mentioned this running game. They've got two or three guys, they've got about 80 to 90 carries apiece. You know, we don't have anybody, I don't think, anywhere close to that.
Right.
One of them's number freshman, Quentin Grace, another guy. You know, they're young. Quentin Grace has 98 carries, 581 yards, and then the quarterback is the second leading rusher on the team with 533.
Mm-hmm.
Then they got another guy that's right at 400, Ricky Woodford. He's number 41. He's a senior.
Right.
And I think you alluded to the receivers, Brian Farlow and Antonio Fitzgerald, numbers 1 and 2, those guys in junior-senior combo. And, they've got about 500 yards receiving, a little more between them. So, they've always got an explosive type offense. You know, they came in here back, I can't remember what year it was, I believe the Merriweather boy was a quarterback. I think that was his name. It was the guy that ended up actually playing in the NBA.
Okay.
He was the quarterback, and we were highly favored in that game. First round game, just like this. They come up here, and they beat us in the first game, and wasn't supposed to. The quarterback was very athletic. He would just drop back, let some lanes open up, and go.
Take
and
off.
We didn't have the fast guys. You know, we were built different back then.
Right.
These guys, we've got some quick guys in the secondary that can prevent a lot of that kind of stuff. You know, we've been up against some fast teams this year that these guys have done a good job on.
Yeah, I hope so. I thought last week that the quarterback scrambling bothered us quite a bit. So one of my biggest concerns definitely is that quarterback running around east-west, finding gaps, and just taking it himself. And just a competitor, 15, the quarterback, number 8, 41, 1 and 2, the guys that you mentioned, they just compete really hard too. And I could think you talk about the early struggles or it's kind of hard to read them. Well, when you've got a freshman quarterback and a freshman ace running back. You know, things could get – you could have ups and downs without a doubt with that, you know, young of a core that you're counting on. So, you know, but the more and more the years went on, I feel like they've seemed to have got better. So we definitely just got to make sure that we're ready to play. Just like you said, when they come in here, this is a team that could definitely come in here and beat us if we're not prepared to play and mentally ready to play. It's not going to be a walk in the park.
Yeah, I was just looking here at the times. I was trying to find that game where we played them back in the day, 1996. That would have been one of Coach Darn's early years. He came, what, 92, I think. We've only played this team 16 times in the history of high school football in Greene County, and we have 11 wins against 5 losses to the Rebels, and that's pretty good because they've had some really good teams over the years.
They have.
Really good teams. Had a team, I'm pretty sure, that went to the state semis one year back in the late 80s, early 90s, and always have some athletes. What do we do? What do these guys, what's their role in keeping this offense in check then this week? Specifically, so these guys, of course, they're corners.
Yeah, safeties. Yeah, we got two. Camron plays free safety and corner, and then he plays the invert, which is a down safety, or some free safety right now, too. So they just got to do their job and keep everything in front of them, make sure they're keeping their guys covered up and being where they're supposed to be in coverage. The guy will break out of the pocket a little bit, and when he does that, their responsibility is to stay in coverage. They got to make sure that they're disciplined like that in those ways, so when that quarterback breaks out that – you know, we don't let something leak out deep and make, you know, what could be a 5 or 6 yard scramble turn into a 50 yard touchdown. So they just got to be disciplined in the scramble attack of staying back. And it's tough, especially if you're, say, in the flat defender, you know, guarding somebody short and the quarterback's running right at you. You got to stay back in your covers and let the defensive line and linebackers handle those situations. So that's their job, just making sure that we don't let scramble drill turn into big plays.
Yeah. So, Caden, you watch a lot of film on the huddle. You watch a lot. Yeah, spend a lot of time.
I haven't watched much film on Todd County, so I'm going to get on that tonight, tomorrow.
But
tonight,
you typically do watch your huddle.
Yeah.
How handy is that to have it on your phone? When do you watch it?
Usually at night, after school, after practice, I'm laying in bed and stuff, try to get, you know, all that information in my head for the next day.
Lay off the TikTok, watch a little huddle for a while. So, Cam, do you watch a lot of film on there?
Yeah, sometimes. It depends.
Yeah? You watch a little TikTok, too?
Yeah, I watch a lot of TikTok.
You make a little TikTok every now and then?
No, I don't like to make them.
No? Why? No. Why not?
I don't like that.
Yeah? I'm going to tell you, he acts like a mild-mannered, shy, you know? I'm going to tell you, he's on a football field. It's totally opposite.
Yeah.
And, in fact, we get a little bit too much.
Sometimes. Yeah. It can happen.
So where is this? It's like the humble shoeshine boy, and then he comes out as Superman when he gets on the field. Yeah. You don't even know that, do you?
No.
That's the old Superman. He went into the phone booth or something.
Yeah.
Comes out as Superman. So what is this metamorphosis, this change when you step on the field from being a quiet guy to being a little different?
You can get my head really easily. So if you say one thing to me, I'm gonna say something.
I'm just talking about your play too, man. Y'all see that? You celebrate a little bit afterwards, and it's
just I don't know, really.
That's a change, isn't it? It's different. I mean, here and now. I mean, why talk to me like that now? I'm bad to the bone. What do you say to those guys when they look at you like that?
I say a lot of stuff.
A lot of stuff
I can't say.
So, Caden, I don't know if I'm going to talk about your favorite route. What are some routes that you like that you feel like, hey, I like that when I get it called? You know, just in general.
I like snaps a lot. Usually snaps hit pretty well. Hitches, posts are always fun to run, you know, take the top off the defense, just stuff like that, you know what I'm saying? So
I'll tell you, the things that he's got to go up and get, he's ripped so good at.
Yeah, he's rangy. He can definitely go up and – I like when I see a 50-50 ball going his way. His way, too. He's a small guy, but he can go up and get it. He got really good ball skills going up in there and getting it.
Yeah. And what was it, last week, blocked the field goal. Sure did. Cam did. Yeah. Blocked the field goal. Yeah. Now – it was granted almost a 60-yard field goal.
51 or 52.
it was over 50 yards. You know, maybe they can make those. I don't know.
He definitely has a very strong leg. Yeah, strong. I'm just not sure. I don't know about that strong, but very strong for sure. You would think that they've at least seen him get that or close to call that in a game.
Sure.
Yeah, you would
think. They were way behind. I mean, well, they were far behind at that point.
No,
at
14.
Yeah, that's right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but Cam. So how did you get around? How did you get through out there and get that one? What do you pride yourself on all that?
You just got to get tight on the line before I go to block it, as the coach says. Normally, the beginning of the season, I didn't used to get tight, but I was playing safety that time, so I had to get tight on that one.
Yeah. So that's your primary. That's just your edge is to get on the edge and get tight on there. Yeah. So what are you thinking when you go back there? What's in your mind?
Well, it depends. I'm reading the end out there, like the tight end. And last week the tight end was scared. He didn't want to block any of us. So I knew that he was going to be there.
Did you tell him he was scared?
No, I could just tell.
You just tell it. Yeah. All right. So. Caden, what have you seen any film at all on Todd
yet? I haven't watched much on Todd this week. Yeah. So
you know, just in general, what do you think that we have to do here to be able to stop their offense?
Just do your job, key on their playmakers, just don't let them make the big plays. That's our game plan coming in this week. Just do your job, getting back to the basics.
Yeah. Well, we're going to take a quick break and visit with our sponsors for just a moment, and we'll come back and talk a little bit about Todd Central's defense and what these guys are going to do offensively against them. We'll be right back. All right, we're back. We're going to talk about this Todd Central Rebel defense, Coach Courtney. What are we going to see out of them defensively? They got some pretty good guys out there. Some more. It seems like seniors that are involved in the defense.
Defensively, yeah. The two freshmen, I don't think, play much defense. But, yeah, they're a 4-2 defense. They'll bring a lot of pressure. They're not going to sit back in that 4-2. They're going to bring a lot of blitzes from inside, outside, do some different things. They have a really big interior tackle, number 62, who's kind of a clogger in the middle, can really be a force down there, especially at times. Fast defensive end, 41, which is one of their running backs that we talked about. What do you think of a running back as a defensive end? He's a small, short dude, but really stocky and quick off the edge that can give you some problems for sure. You know, so they're going to get man coverage. They're going to get some cover three. Just going to get a mix-up defense. I feel like it'll be aggressive defense, more aggressive than we are typically seeing.
Their lead tackler is Kenyron Coleman, number 59. Is he a defensive end?
Yeah, defensive end.
He's got 76 tackles, 14 tackles for loss, 2 sacks, and some forced fumbles. And then their second leading tackler is number 7. I don't know,
he's probably their best defensive player, and I left him out. I watched too much offense.
Sean Gardner.
Yeah, he is. I believe he's listed as quarterback, and I believe he used to be their quarterback. You know, before this freshman took over,
he played safety,
and now he plays free safety. Yeah. Man, as he plays free safety the way you're supposed to play it, he's downhill when he sees a run. He's tackling at 5 or 6 yards. I've even seen him like down making tackles for loss down there. I'm not sure. It's hard to tell if he's blitzing or if he's just reading it that fast. But really athletic. Rangy kid will come up and hit. Probably their best defensive player, honestly, and I forgot to mention him.
Yeah. And the Travis Eden's another one, number 20.
Inside backer. Yeah.
So you guys offensively, what you like offense or defense better? I bet both of you like offense better.
Yeah,
I like offense better.
Yeah.
So, you know, right now – I think you're the leading receiver yards-wise on the team this season. I think, Cam, you're somewhere down around 4 or 5, somewhere on the team. You've got, what, 600-plus yards? Do you keep that on – it's not on your – you don't have it written on your hand?
No, I don't really stat track, but I think it's probably around there.
Yeah, I don't have that up here right here right away. But you can see all that on the Rocket website. Andy Hunt compiles all that stuff and keeps it. In fact, I think I've got some files I need to get uploaded. He sent me the other day onto the site. Here we go. So, Caden Howard has 50. Ooh, well, it's scoring. Bear with me here. 539 yards receiving on 51 catches. And then Cam, he's got 198 yards on 17 catches. So it sounds like you're going to win the debate. You need to start, I guess, plead your case a little more for some touches. So you're kind of behind a little bit.
I was going to split carries with Tyler. So, I mean, it goes both ways.
Yeah. So, you mentioned Tyler. Tyler didn't play a whole lot last week. Tyler Belt, we're talking about, who's a very key weapon in our offense and a good defender, too. And he didn't play any defense last week.
No,
he didn't. We thought that he had broken his collarbone the week before at home. Turns out he didn't, which is very fortunate for us. Mm-hmm. How's he doing, and what's the rest of the team looking like?
He looks to be doing really good. We didn't expect for him, honestly, to play last Friday, but being a senior and he felt good, you know, kind of made like a big improvement from Thursday to Friday and was really feeling good. So he had been out there at practice. We had just kept him out of contact, so I felt like he had practiced all week and just felt like probably the smartest thing was to do just let him play some receiver and if he wanted to play, and he did. And he was able to make some big plays there. Yeah. But this week seems to be back to normal. Said he feels as good as he ever has, so I think we'll be back to – you know, his full role and doing whatever he can. It's a senior year in the playoffs. You know, there's not – you know, there's everything to lose now. So he's got – I think he knows that he wants to be out there as much as he possibly can. And Cam did a great job because Cam's basically takes both of those roles over 100%, which he has some of those duties anyway. He's out there probably 50% of the time, 75% of the time, something like that, defensively at least, and offensively. I'm not sure the rotation, but – he did a great job filling in for him and didn't miss a beat defensively. Played really well the last 2 weeks. It was a good job by him. Gatton, Travis, he played a lot of defense. With being a running back and having a shoulder issue, we thought it was probably better for him to play more defense, honestly, to not take as much contact on his shoulder. And he seems to be doing fine as well, seems to be back. So, and then who else we have? Travis Bazina's sprained ankle was really bad, but man, he fought through that like a champ. Even last week, you couldn't even tell he was hurt, but his ankle was really big and blue and purple and all kinds of colors. So, but we're seeing we're back to healthy, as healthy as anybody is this year. Everybody's got bumps and bruises and hurt, in certain ways. That's what this game is. So, but I would say we're as healthy as you could ask for at this point of the year.
You know, we're 10 games in, and I don't we haven't had a season ending injury. Mm-hmm. Knock on wood, Noah. Right. You kind of called me out a couple of weeks ago.
Hopefully that was our little run.
So you cross your fingers, knock on wood, whatever you do. But that's nice place to be.
Playing that schedule, that's what you were. Yeah. That's the only thing I was concerned with. I really was not competing, but if we get hurt in that schedule and have to play a bunch of reserves and those type things. But we've been extremely blessed, and that's all I can mark it up to. Tyree had the bad injury and missed a lot of the year, but still, I mean, is able to come back and been playing for what, 3 or 4 weeks now. That seems like a lifetime ago now, and he's been able to get back. So that's the worst injury we've had. So been really lucky so far.
So let's get these guys on here and talk a little bit more before we sign off. We'll start on this side. And so I'm going to ask you, these are just kind of goofy questions, So I'll ask you some goofy questions. But we like to find what goes on in the locker room and all. People like to know more about you. So I'm going to ask, Cam, what if you left your phone at home, you left your phone at home, and the game's getting ready to kick off, and you borrow your earbud from somebody so you can – you're in the locker room, you're getting ready. Whose earbud are you going to borrow so you get some good music? Who's got the good playlist?
Probably Levi Piper.
Levi Piper?
Yeah.
Who's got the
– Caden, maybe.
Caden, yeah. Yeah, what kind of stuff? I mean, who's some artists?
anyone. We listen to anything, really.
Yeah. Well, you're gonna. What do they listen to? That's the one you want. I mean, you got Barry's ear.
I mean, we all listen to the same music, so.
Yeah. Who are the artists? Anybody I know?
Probably not.
No, Waylon Jennings, Hank Jr. No. None of that. No. George Strait.
Mm-mm.
Dang.
There's not much country.
Used to be, man. Used to be back when you played.
Even when I played,
a lot of Hank Jr. I know. Who's got the lame tunes on their
Probably Lane West.
It's probably the Hank. And
yeah, he's probably all the country music. Yeah. Yeah. You don't like it at all. No. All right. So, you know, you're a junior. You got another year to play. What are you looking for out of this this playoff? You mean you've got another year, so it's not like some of these seniors are going to it like, hey, I gotta get them there. So, I mean, you've got them on your mind. You got to help carry them through and get them to the next week. Because at this point, you win or go home or be done. So, what's your role? What's going on this week? What are you thinking about?
Just the experience, helping the seniors get a win where it don't end, and backing up Tyler every time, and just helping us get the win.
What's your favorite part about playing at Rocket State?
Probably the home games.
Yeah.
The crowd.
Yeah.
Crowd's loud.
Yeah. Get you fired up a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you look up in the stands and see people, or do you pay any attention?
The student section. I got some of my friends over there.
Yeah. Your fan section?
Yeah.
Yeah. Are they on the front row?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen them down there. So, Caden, you're just a sophomore, and you're already touching on some of these records. And I know we don't want to get into personal stuff too much as far as records go, but what's something you got your eye on? You got to set goals. Is there any – you said you're not a records stat watcher, but you have your hearts. I mean, what, Ethan Dossett's got that receiving rare. I mean, what are you after? What's the crown jewel other than wins?
Everybody's kind of after that touchdown record, so yeah. I mean, I'd have to say probably the touchdown record. Probably what I got my eyes on the most.
Receiving touchdown record.
Yeah.
Not the yards, not the reception.
No, that's probably more than the touchdowns, more than anything else, but
because that's what wins games, right?
Right.
6 points add up.
Yeah, they do.
That's right. Yeah. So, what about you? You know, we've got the playing at home at Rocket Stadium. They've got the new little balloon, the tunnel you run out. You know, blow. You like that? I mean, what is it? What really fires you? At what moment is it in a locker room? Is it coming through that tunnel? Is it when you hit the sideline? Is it when the fans get up? What gets you going?
Really, just running out of that tunnel and seeing all them fans is when it all hits you, you know, when it all sets in. In the locker room, you're kind of just anticipating it, ready for it to happen, and then you get out there and it's real. And that's probably when.
What song does Vicky play when y'all hit the field? Do you know?
I don't even know.
Back to the Purge.
Yeah, the Purge is that was my favorite when we do that one.
Yeah. All right, Coach Courtney, you're gonna get to walk this one off, man. You're in the playoffs. This is like we said, it's eat what you kill now or it's over. Yeah. So what do you got this week? What's the plan?
No, just to go out there and play the best we can play. Just put it together. I don't feel like we've ever put it together all year long. I really don't. And you know, we've had a successful year, and I'm not downing our kids or the team. I'm proud of what we've done, but it's more, I believe more in them than what we've done. I really do. I don't think we've put it together yet. I think the best of us haven't been seen, and I'm just hoping that it is seen this week. That's been the message. Just put it together. Can we put it together, offense, defense, special teams? Penalties, everything. Everything. Can we play one solid game? Because we haven't seen that yet. You can go look through that, and there's always something. Can we put it all together this week on the playoffs? There's no better time. These seniors, it's on the line for them. I remember what that felt like, and I'll never forget it, and I want to make sure I'm doing everything I possibly can. Mm-hmm. And these younger guys understand it's not about them. It's always about their brother, and these seniors need to be put in the forefront right now. Continue to make the memories with them. That's probably the biggest thing. You'll never have these memories with these guys again. I'll never get to coach these guys again. You know, you got to cherish those times. Cherish every practice, every time you're in the locker room with them, and try to create more of them because, you know, those memories are what's going to be most important at the end.
Yeah. See that running game put up some yards this week too.
Maybe. Right. Yeah, exactly.
That'd be a good playoff wish list for me.
Exactly.
So Todd Central comes in here, we get this win, and then we have to go up tall task after that, and we end up over in Owensboro and see the Aces again. We had a little trouble with them first time, but we were in it. We were in it for a while against them, and then they just kind of busted some on them, made some mistakes, let them get away. So you guys looking forward to playing them again?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm
ready. Up there at their place on the turf too. It's a little different up there, so.
Right now we're focused on this one.
Yeah,
absolutely. So Todd Central coming in on Friday night, coming to Rocket Stadium. First time they've been there in about 5 years. I think they came in and it was 5 or 6 years, maybe back in the late teens, 17, 18, 19, somewhere in there. But we'll have Todd Central here, kickoff 7 p.m. Go fan, get your tickets. $8 a head, right?
Yeah, and everybody, and passes aren't good.
Passes aren't good.
That's KHSA rules. Yeah. So
big night at Rocket Stadium. If you hadn't seen these guys this season, get out there for the playoffs. Going to be good weather this Friday night. We'll see you out at Rocket Stadium. Here we go for the 2A playoffs.